On January 14th, a Russian A-50 Mainstay Airborne Early Warning and Control AEW&C aircraft was shot down over the Sea of Azov. This is one of the most significant hits Ukraine has been able to execute since the conflict started. There was a lot of speculation about how Ukraine managed to do this, since this was a long-range hit. According to a U.S. Army officer, a U.S.-made Patriot air defense system was used for this. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S.-made Patriot air defense system was able to take out a Russian A-50. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Speaking on a panel at the United States Field Artillery Association's Fires Symposium 2024 last week, Colonel Rosanna Clemente, Assistant Chief of Staff at the 10th Army Air and Missile Defense Command, confirmed that the A-50 fell to a German-provided Patriot system in what she described as a SAMBUSH, or surface-to-air missile ambush. Colonel Clemente explained, "They've probably about a battalion of Patriots operating in Ukraine right now. Some of it is being used to protect static sites and critical national infrastructure. Others are being moved around and doing some really, really historic things that I haven't seen in 22 years of being an air defender, and one of them is a SAMBUSH. They're doing that with extremely mobile Patriot systems that were donated by the Germans because the systems are all mounted on the trucks. So they're moving around and they're using these types of systems, bringing them close to the plot, and stretching the very, very edges of the kinematic capabilities of that system to engage the first A-50C2 command and control system back in January. The Russian aircraft BERIEV A-50, also known as Mainstay by NATO, has command and control capabilities and the ability to track a large number of targets. The BERIEV A-50 is a Soviet-era AEW&C aircraft. It was based on the Ilyushin IL-76MD heavy military transport aircraft fitted with a huge search radar. This was essentially a response to the US E-3 Sentry AWACS aircraft, which appeared a couple of years earlier. The A-50 made its first flight in 1978. The type reached initial operational capability in 1982. Some sources report that the type entered service in 1985. Production ceased in 1992 after the collapse of the Soviet Union and with the end of the Cold War. A total of 40 to 42 A-50 series aircraft were built, including modernized and export variants. By 2011, the Russian Air Force operated 20 of these aircraft. Some sources report that in 2022, Russia operated only 9 A-50 aircraft, including 3 upgraded A-50M and 6 A-50U aircraft. However, it's unclear how many of these aircraft were airworthy. The main role of the aircraft is to detect, identify, and track airborne targets and warships at sea. Data from the A-50 aircraft is transferred to command centers. This aircraft also provides guidance data to fighter aircraft and missiles. The Schmel radar is mounted on a large rotodome above the rear fuselage. The Schmel radar can detect bomber aircraft at a range of 650 kilometers or about 400 miles. Fighter aircraft and warships at ranges of 300 kilometers or 186 miles, and short-range ballistic missiles at ranges of 800 kilometers or about 500 miles. It can track 200 to 300 aerial targets simultaneously and provide guidance data for a group of up to 30 fighter jets. A-50 has an endurance of 9 to 10 hours. It also has an in-flight refueling probe, which can extend its flight range. The unit price of a used A-50 is around $330 million and around $500 million in upgraded A-50U form. The Patriot Air Defense System is an all-weather tactical mobile air defense system. The system has the ability to engage against cruise and ballistic missiles, drones, as well as different types of aircraft. The Patriot PAC-3 uses a passively electronically scanned array radar. The radar has a range of more than 160 kilometers or 100 miles. The system was introduced with MIM-104A. Progressively upgraded missiles were added like MIM-104B, known as PAC-1, and MIM-104C, known as PAC-2. The latest one is PAC-3 MSE. The range and operational altitude vary depending on the missile type. For aerial targets like aircraft and drones, the PAC-3 MSE missile has an engagement range of 120 kilometers or 75 miles, whereas for ballistic missiles, it has a range of about 60 kilometers or around 37 miles. It's likely that Ukraine received different types of missiles from its Western partners. At a cost of approximately $1.1 billion, the Patriot represents the most expensive individual weapons system that's been provided to Ukraine. Despite Kyiv's appeals to the Pentagon for the weapons since the beginning of the war, the first Patriot systems were sent much later. Russia has not been able to establish air superiority over Ukraine. This means that any Russian aircraft operating over or even near the border is susceptible to ambush. A-50's impressive radar range means that it didn't have to fly deep inside Ukraine, but could keep maintaining distance from known air defense threats and still do its job. But it seems the Russian mission planners didn't take into account the Ukrainian ingenuity and Patriot system's ability to be shifted swiftly. The Patriot system is modular and highly mobile. A battery-sized element can be installed in less than an hour. In this case, the Patriot system was moved closer to the battle line, and an ambush was executed with a typical hit-and-run tactic. The high-value aircraft, one of only a handful immediately available to Russia, was the first of two brought down in the space of 5 weeks. Another one was supposedly brought down by a Soviet-era S-200 SAM system. The loss of the A-50 is a significant setback, as these aircraft are crucial for detecting incoming cruise missile and drone attacks, as well as low-flying fighter sorties. Additionally, they provide command and control and situational awareness for Russian fighters and air defense units.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.